Oh yes, and another video is simply put, the crucifixion of Jesus did not save anybody's soul from hell. When Jesus got murdered, that took the spirit of God off of the planet, which caused doorways in hell to open, which caused humanity to get destroyed and tortured and punished. Humanity was not made better because Jesus got crucified. That is not what happened. Jesus was never supposed to get crucified, but because the church didn't want the truth of how God really felt about it to go through the earth, the church murdered Jesus so the truth would never go forward. Then they lied and said it was supposed to happen that way, and it was not. Jesus was never supposed to die on that cross, but he got murdered, but he didn't fight it because he's like, look, y'all can accept the truth or y'all can kill it, but at the end of the day, y'all decisions will be either make y'all better or it'll make y'all worse. I can't force you to learn, and I'm not going to fight you on it. Either you're going to learn or you're not. That's just what it is. And the fact that he got murdered proved one thing, that the church don't want to hear the truth and they ain't ready for it, and humanity ain't ready for it. That's why Jesus, he ain't came back just yet, at this time period anyway. And the other thing is, people keep saying that Jesus died on the cross for their sins. No, he didn't, because y'all say he wiped your sins away and wiped your slate clean. Now you're a new person, and sin's no longer in your life. And if that was the case, then why are you still on earth? Because sinless beings belong in the heavens. That's where perfection is, not on earth. Sinless beings can't survive on earth because earth is a balance of good and evil. If you claim he wiped your sin away, then your spirit should already be back in the heavens. Yeah, that's how you know that's a lie, because he didn't do that. And you should automatically know the truth if he truly died for it, because it should be embedded in you. Just like everything else, the truth should be embedded in you, but it's not. It's something you have to learn. That's all I'm saying. And last but not least, Jesus did have a wife who tried to spread the truth of him to the world, tried to trust the church and take it to the church. The church threw her in jail, changed the teaching so it would fit with a bunch of sexist men wanted it to. That's why the church and religion in general is sexist. Men just don't want to listen to women because they think women are inferior to them because of the Adam and Eve thing. Eve ate the apple, which caused humanity to fall into sin and punishment and all that stuff. Basically, a woman deceived a man, which ruined humanity. And all that stuff. So yeah, just think about that. If Jesus really died for your sin, why are you still on earth? Why? You should be in the heavens relaxing, not worrying about sin that was taken from you. And if you truly wiped your sin away, why do you still have to suffer? Why does the devil still punish you? Why does he still mess with you? Why do you still go through stuff? Why do you have to go to church to repent for sin that shouldn't exist? Why do you have to ask God for forgiveness for committing a sin that shouldn't exist? Why do you have to keep praying to God to help you overcome a sin that should not exist? Why do you have to keep praying to God to heal you from an illness which happens from sin that shouldn't exist? Because all sin is a lower form of living and thinking. Anything that makes you worse as a person or hurts you is a sin. Illness is a sin. So I just want you to realize that. If Jesus really died for your sins, why is all that not fixed? Why do you still feel pain, anger, envy, jealousy, lust, malice, all that? Why? He never carried your sin away. The church just made it seem like he did, to make their own selfish intentions both look and sound good. And also, communion is not a good thing because you're eating the body of Jesus and drinking his blood, which is vampirism, and cannibalism, which is a sin. And the reason why them pastors washed their hands in that water, it represents when Jesus got crucified, what was his name? King Tiberius washed his hands from the responsibility of murdering Jesus. That's why these popes and stuff can have sex with little boys and not get punished for it, because technically they ain't responsible for the murder of Jesus. Y'all are, as the church and humanity is in general. And also, the reason why popes have sex with little boys and not women and they have sex with trannies is because they don't ever want to mix their perfect genetics with those of sinners, because then punishment can be brought to them. So yeah, they're only having sex with trannies and little boys, so they never impregnate a woman because of the bad history of Eve and all that other stuff. So just letting you know that. So if you ever wonder why popes keep molesting little boys and having sex with trannies, it's because they fear if they ever had sex with an actual woman, they're going to get punished for that murder. So, yeah. I'm out.